Hey guys, what's up? It's Apollo here. Hope you guys are doing well, and I welcome you back to Empire Total War. I know it's been a while, but it's good to be back, and this is a subscribers battle replay. Now, the battle itself is not historical, but it's set in a historical setting, and I think you guys really enjoy that. I really enjoy it, because I love the backstory and the feeling of like, okay, why are these guys fighting? What's the issue here? You can really, it's the immersion, I think, that really draws people in, because a couple days ago, I did a battle called the Polish Ambush, which is a battle set in or during the Polish Teutonic Wars of the 1300s. And though the battle was not historical, I think a lot of people really enjoyed the historical immersion. And I'm definitely going to try to work on that or do more of that on my channel. Have battles that aren't necessarily historical, but set during a historical time. I think that's pretty cool. So this is actually during the Great Northern War, which is a war between Russia and Sweden during the early 1700s. And the person who sent this in, his name is Chris. So thank you, Chris, for the battle replay. He actually wrote up a little bit of a backstory here, so I want to share that with you guys because I think you'll really enjoy it. It's the dying days of the Great Northern War, the height of summer 1720. A hastily assembled Swedish force is moving up the Baltic coast in the hazy days of August from a landing near East Prussia. The target? St. Petersburg. During the march one evening, they found a Russian force drawn up on a slight rise on the coast. Peter the Great has brought together his forces to stop the invasion and bring an end to the war. The Swedes have no option. Form up and attack. That's what we see right here. So let's go ahead and look at these army comps. We're gonna do some slow motion. Hopefully we don't get too far ahead of ourselves. I don't think we'll see any action. It does take a little while for these armies to meet on the battlefield, but let's start with Russia here. So Russia is the army commanded by the person who sent it in, Chris. He's bringing in a couple riflemen. So he's got about 4 units of rifles, which are great, of course, at skirmishing down the enemy. And then he's got some Cossack infantry. So these are lesser troops, so kind of like militia. I think obviously he's going to be using them more as a meat shield, maybe to scout ahead. You know, if you lose them, it's not that big of a deal, but he's got about 3-4 units of them, so nice to see the Cossack in the Russian army. And then back here, of course, he has his Russian line infantry with those beautiful coats. I love these uniforms. So he's got, let's see, he's got 2 units of guards, so let me say that first. He's got the more elite guards, and then for his standard infantry, he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units of line infantry. Now back here, he has his general. This would be Peter the Great. And then way over here, he's got some horse artillery, the 6-pounder horse artillery. And he is bringing lots of cav. So he's got the Cossack cav, so 2 units of Cossack cav. And then I think he has about 2 units of hussars and 1 unit of light dragoons. That's pretty much it for the Russian army. Let's move over to the Swedish army, where he's already advancing. He's pushing up a lot of Swedish riflemen. So he's got about 4 units of rifles. Again, he's going to use them to scout ahead and use their long range, their accuracy. And then back here, he has his line infantry. So here's the Swedish line infantry. I think he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units of line infantry. So lots and lots of line infantry. Back here, he does have a pretty solid cav force to match the Russian cav. So he's got light dragoons. And so 2 units of light dragoons, heavy cavalry. And then back here, he has his general's bodyguard. He is also bringing a 6-pounder horse artillery. You can't see it, I don't believe, but I think it's setting up right about here. And then he also has some elite troops, some lifeguards of foot. So we can go back to normal speed and really enjoy this fight. Okay, so yeah, after looking at the army comps, the armies definitely seem almost like mirror images. They're very similar. I think Russia has a little bit more cav and less infantry compared to Sweden. Well, actually, I shouldn't say less infantry, but they have, I would say, lower quality infantry because of the Cossack infantry. So it should be really interesting to see how Russia uses them in this fight. Now, this is also really cool because if you look at the terrain, it's definitely in favor in the Russians because they do have that slight rise. They have the high ground. But Sweden has the forest. So Sweden can use, because trees definitely help shield your troops. Now, it's a double-edged sword because it's difficult to fire out of the forest as well. But you can set up some ambushes. You see his troops have disappeared there. So the element of surprise is in favor of Sweden. But Russia, again, has the high ground. So I think really what it's going to come down to is the artillery. How effective is the artillery going to be? And we already have some shots here knocking down... was so dramatic, knocking down some Swedish forces in the forest. So again, I think the positioning here of the Russian artillery is fantastic. You can't really ask for a better position. You got this small little hill he can fire from. And there we go. Now we got Sweden's artillery trying to fire down. And again, the positioning here for Russian, or for Russia, I should say, is actually really good. This slight slope is protecting them from the Swedish horse artillery. He is moving up some Cossack infantry over the walls. And I just love this map right here. I've never actually seen this map before. I don't think so. I don't remember it. I don't really play a lot of Empire, but it's great to see this really cool cinematic map. And I really like the atmosphere of this battle. It's pretty sweet. But here comes the Cossack infantry. They are taking some casualties as the Russian rifles fire down. The rest of the infantry pouring down. So I think he's going to make an aggressive move here. Maybe, again, he's just scouting ahead using the Cossack infantry. So they're going to charge forward. They are going for the artillery. I think he thinks that it's not protected. But we do have the elite lifeguards afoot. They're now advancing forward. They're going to protect that artillery. The Cossack infantry. They might be trying to get a shot off here. Yes, they do get a shot. Only getting a couple casualties, nothing to it. Well, actually, they took out about 17 men there. But the lifeguards afoot, they are not going to stop. They're not going to fire. They're going to go right for a bayonet charge. And they should just crush the Cossack infantry. So, yeah, they're already breaking. You can see their banner starting to waver. Flashing white. That is the symbol for retreat. And that is a solid stand from the Swedish lifeguards afoot. They're going to fall back. Back to the safety of their artillery. So that was the beginning stage of the fight. We also had another charge over on this side. I think he was just trying to surprise the rifles. Did not really pay off. I think they got a couple kills on the rifles, but nothing too effective. And the Cossack infantry is already on the run. So it's a pretty rough start. It's a pretty rough start so far for the Russians. But again, they have the high ground, you know, so they should definitely take things slow. Oh, look at that artillery hit. Didn't kill anyone, but it looked like it should have killed someone. That would look like a direct hit. But yeah, Russia should take their time, use their artillery. They've lined up some of their cav over on the right flank. Now, Sweden is going to try to match their cav. They're also moving their cav, which would be their left flank. So let's see what happens here. Sweden's now moving a little bit quicker, so he might make a move here, might make a strike. We've got line infantry lining up on this side as well. So we got some line infantry from Sweden appearing on the battlefield. I think they're going to try to move them up and use the safety of the stone wall as a bit of a stand here. Now, I don't know if these stone walls actually give your troops protection, but they certainly look cool. And it's definitely going to add that immersion to the battle. So, you know, you can't complain. But because of the Russian, since the Russian army has superior cav as in numbers, they're able to split up their cav forces. Sweden's not really doing that. So here, let me actually slow it down here and just give you a bird's eye view and show you what I'm talking about. The fact that Sweden is dedicating all of his cav on one flank, Russia has plenty of opportunity to use this cav as a very aggressive flanking unit to surprise the infantry, and Sweden will not be able to send over reinforcements in time because all of his cav is dedicated over to the left flank. So let's press play again and see what's going on here. So the Russian cav falling back because they're trying to stay out of range of the line infantry that's forming up over on this side. So that's a smart idea. Good map awareness there. You don't know how many times I've seen people lose cav just sitting there because they're so focused on a different part of the battlefield. The Swedish artillery still firing. If you look at their angle, it's not exactly a great angle. There's a big hill in the way. You can't really see a lot of the Russian troops, and that's just really unfortunate for the Swedish army. He probably should have set up his artillery back here. Now, I don't know the range of the artillery, but it seems like he's having a lot of difficulty here. But the good thing about setting up the artillery so close to the front lines is that you can use canister shot. So it's definitely not disaster here. All right, so Sweden's foreman finally getting behind the walls. Now, is he actually kneeling and using the walls? Is like the gameplay actually like trying to do that? I don't think so, but I think they're just reloading or just waiting, or maybe they're hidden. No, they're not hidden. If they were hidden, we wouldn't be able to see them. All right, let's see what's going on here. We actually have some Cossack cav going for a charge right down the center lines. A very bold move. I don't know if they're going to try to go for some rifles. Actually, hold the phone, guys. Hold the phone. We got some cav charging down here. We got Hussars moving past the line infantry. And, oh, we do have a line battle. So I think what he's going to try to do here is a hammer and anvil. The line infantry holding down the Russian line. And they are going to get some shots. And we're gonna slow-mo here once again. Look how cool this, I just wanted to show you this because this looks so awesome. The Swedish line infantry using the stone walls. Every time they need to reload, they kneel and just take cover. That is amazing. Back here, the Russian hussars. This is excellent. This is exactly what you want to see. But Sweden needs to quickly send over something. He is sending over his lifeguards afoot, but I don't think they're gonna get there fast enough. So let's go back to normal speed. And sure enough, the hussar is going to charge in. I don't know if he's paying attention. I don't know. I am pretty sure the line infantry can form square, but it looks like a disaster for Sweden as they were not prepared for that hussar tactic there. Very fast strike. They're going to disengage, and now the line infantry is going to do a bayonet charge. Excellent hit and run tactics. There they go. Now they form square, but it's too late. The Russian line infantry. Nope, he's not. All right, for a second, I thought he was going to go for a volley, but instead he decided to charge back in. What the heck? Go in. Attack. Why are you kneeling at the wall? Just go in and fight. So we got this massive bayonet fight here. This is epic. Is the cav going to commit back into the fight? They can certainly need the support. We got more gunfire down here. The rifles firing down on the lifeguards afoot for Sweden. Let's slow-mo here. Let's see what's going on this side. Nothing yet, but the Russian cav is still waiting patiently here. What happened to that Cossack cav? Did he commit them into the fight? Did he run them into some stakes? I don't know. Unfortunately, we missed it because of all the action over on this side. But yeah, here comes a charge. Look at this. The hussars moving in, getting behind the Swedish line infantry. And that should be the nail in the coffin for this this right flank for Sweden. And of course, the left flank for Russia. So this is going to be a big issue for Sweden. I don't know how they're going to recover from this. They probably should play a little bit more defensive in the tree line because they lost his flank. Well, actually, he still has his lifeguards. They could try to turn this one around, but they've got to bring down a lot of units. We've got Peter the Great back here giving his troops extra morale. Sweden's starting to break. Is that it? No, that's his line infantry. Now we've got the general. The general from Sweden is committing to the fight, which is pretty unbelievable because I don't know why you would want to throw your general in a losing battle like this or a losing skirmish. And the canister shot from Sweden's artillery. That is awfully dangerous to fire a canister shot in a big mass where your general is fighting in. But Sweden is just going for it. He's just going with the YOLO tactics. And the general is certainly in danger. He needs to try to get him out of there. In fact, the general is breaking from the battlefield. Now Russia is moving forward. Okay, so yeah, the general is dead. Now with the death of the general, things are looking really good for Russia. Russia pushing up their riflemen. He's going to try to soften up the troops in the force. He's feeling pretty confident that he's going to be able to withstand anything Sweden has in here because of the death of the general. The morale is going to really suffer for Sweden. And also with the flank, winning the flank over on this side, they're now going to be able to put pressure on this side. Now Sweden is sending over some line infantry reserve to try to contain this, really just to stop the bleeding, try to contain this side. Here comes another charge from the hussars. Do they form square in time? They do, but they do have to get ready for some line infantry, so I don't know how long they can form in square, but they should be able to kill the hussars. They're down to 12 men, so it's not like they're going to be super effective here on out on the rest of the battle. Let's slow-mo it once again. Russians, beautiful. Of course, you got to use the Russians like this. Massive bayonet charges. I love to see that. So they're just nonstop, not going to slow down this attack over on this right Swedish flank. So they're going to keep pushing on that side. Over in the center, whoa, we've actually got a cav charge. Oh my god, this is why we got to do slow motion. There's so much going on in this battle. But the cav charge from Sweden, which is pretty smart, but he's already messed up. He needs to fall back. Once you go in, you get a good hit on the rifleman, which is what he did. The issue here is that the guards have formed square, and now we have Russian hussars and light dragoons coming around this way to, again, kneel, like, put the nail... what is the phrase? Nail in the coffin. That's what I was going for. Go in and just win this fight. Oh, and we've got the canister shot coming in as well, which is a little risky with having so many friendlies nearby. But because of that canister shot, because of the flanking cav, the Cossacks coming in, and the square formation, they were able to obliterate that cav. So once again, I want to do slow motion, talk a little bit about the tactics here and what he did wrong. I mentioned it before, but he should have just charged in, hit and run. Remember, when you have fast cav like hussars or light dragoons, Go in, go out. Do not hang around. Don't become friends with the enemy, because they will butcher you if you stay there for prolonged engagements. So that's going to be it for the Swedish Cav. There is a little bit of a fight going on here. We got line infantry taking on the light dragoons. So I like how Russia's attacking the Swedish lines, because I'm sure the player is so focused over on this fight. So it's a little bit of a surprise attack there from Russia. Let's go back to normal speed. As Sweden tries to patch things up, they're definitely feeling the might of Russia right now, and the high ground is not really helping them out either. The riflemen pushing forward, they do have some stakes nearby, but I don't know, it's looking pretty rough, and now the Russians are moving in. They've got, I think, well, there is no balance of power, I don't see one, so... But I think it's safe to say that so far this battle is in favor of Russia. The Russian line infantry is still trying to fight it out over on this flank. We've got extra reserves from Sweden. Now Russia is closing in. I'm feeling like we might get an epic bayonet charge coming up, because that's certainly what it's looking like. Or he's just getting ready for a nice line battle. Just closing in on the Swedish lines. Oh, we got some cav pushing forward. Actually, look at this. The Swedish rifles charging into melee. They're going to fall back, though. Wow, that is a gutsy play there, but it is paying off. They're breaking the Russian rifles. Go, get him! Get him! Huzzah! Oh, he died. What happened? I think he got shot in the back. Oh, geez, yeah. Yeah, the riflemen are feeling that. Feeling those Russian lines firing down on their position. Things are getting a little messy here in the forest. Lots of chaos. Lots of confusion. And again, the Russian rifles continue to soften up the Swedish lines. Let's see if he goes. See, no, he's still hanging back. It's hard to tell what Sweden has at this point, because I bet a lot of his troops are still hidden in the forest. So it's hard to tell like how much of an army he has left. But I can tell you one thing: they're certainly losing this battle, and they need a miracle to turn this one around, especially after the death of their general. But thankfully, over on this flank, Sweden is stopping the bleeding. But here comes the massive bayonet charge. Actually, no, just one unit charging in. Yeah, so he's actually setting up some reinforcements because he realizes he's losing on this flank. So he's going to try to surround the Swedish line infantry. And over here, the rifles continue to fight. The cav is now maneuvered over to the side. Kazakhs formed up. He's got his light dragoons also formed up as well. And I do see some troop movement over here. Yes, we've got some guards pushing forward. I think he's just getting a little bit closer. Remember, the closer you get to the enemy, the more accurate you will become. Nice flanking fire from the Kazakh cavalry. And the... Oh, Sweden. Sweet, sweet Sweden. He's forming defensive formations. He realizes he's outnumbered, so he can't go toe-to-toe with the Russians. So he's got to form a bit of a U-shape to try to contain all of these forces, because the cav is really firing it down at their flank. This is definitely a hazy battle. Hazy battlefield. Line infantry getting some good shots there. So we got a nice line battle going on. We got this one soldier. He's just like, what do I do? These stakes, I can't form up. This is too much. What is going on? More artillery coming down. Oh, great fire from the Russian line infantry. There we go. No more shots. I love how you can, like, ripple fire or fire by rank in this game. Look, they're doing fire by rank. That is amazing. That is so cool. It's cool to see it, but it doesn't really work out in the game, which is pretty unfortunate. All right, so he's got line infantry hidden in the trees. So, I mean, honestly, with the number difference, I assume the number difference, because, again, I don't know if this is the entire Swedish army. I think Russia should just do what Russia does best, charge in with the bayonets and end this one once and for all. He does have some cav flanking around. He's got more of his Cossacks, I think, just running down the breaking troops. Maybe he's going to go for the artillery. Oh, what was that? Is that the artillery shot? What kind of artillery shot was that? Did you see that come in? Right at the side of the line infantry. But yeah, he's got more line infantry closing in. Here we go. Here comes the massive bayonet charge. So this is the Russian style, and they should be able to crumble these Swedish lines. There we go. So keep on pouring in. Now they got to take on some lifeguards afoot. It's going to be a little bit more challenging on this flank, but you know, they've got the numbers. They should be able to handle these troops. And more guards coming around. So I think they're forming up. I think they're going to fire, or no, they're just hanging. Yeah, Sweden's instantly breaking. They don't even need these guards right here, but they're going to fire at the troops for retreating from the back. Now, Empire glitches out and shows that I was actually in the battle, but that's not the case. I'm sorry for the person who sent this in. His name is Chris, so thank you, dude, for sending in the battle replay. This was a pretty decisive victory, but I thought there was a lot of cool tactical, great tactics is what I'm trying to say, from both players. But Sweden, unfortunately, he just lost on the flanks. He wasn't able to contain this flank, and the Russian cav was just too much, and that really sealed the deal. But I really enjoyed this fight because of how tactical, and the players seemed to be, seemed to know what they were doing. It's just Sweden. Another thing is he shouldn't have thrown in his general. I think at that moment when he was losing this flank on this side, he should have fallen back maybe to this hill, and because sometimes you got to give up certain areas. You just got to give it up. If you keep fighting for it, it will be disaster. But the armies were pretty similar in size. The losses were not similar. The kills were not similar. If we look at the stats here, let's see who did the best for the Russians. The Light Infantry, 137. But the Guards, both second and third, 112, 107. So great kill. Oh, the Horse Artillery getting 104. That's pretty impressive for artillery. But yeah, great battle here. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. And remember, I'm always looking for battles in historical settings. So if you guys have any cool replays, let me know. I'm certainly going to try to use my Steam group and announce when I'm going to do some battles. I have some pretty cool historical battle ideas that we can try to recreate. But thank you guys once again so much for watching. It means a lot. I mean, this is so cool. I love just uploading videos and seeing the hilarious comments and just being a part of the community is really awesome. So thank you guys so much, and I'll see you next time.